master at work.
You ready? Let's go. Yeah. For those of you that want to know what we're all about, it's like this, y'all. This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power of will, 5% pleasure, 50% pain, and 100% reason.
Now, the old definition of character is doing what's right when nobody's looking. And this is what we're talking about when we talk about characters. Doing what's right when nobody's looking. Okay. Which brings me to an issue that started up earlier this year when Eric Gordon, the young man from North Central High School over in Indianapolis, had committed to Illinois verbally. And then later on, there were some changes in the recruitment. Indiana got hot on his trail, and the next thing you know, Eric Gordon changed his verbal commitment from Illinois and then decided to go to Indiana. And Illinois fans on a lot of radio talk shows around here
dogged him out.
Just dogged him out and talked about character. And some of the comments that people made about Eric Gordon, those are not the type of kids we want around here.
Don't even know the guy now.
Don't know him from Adam.
This is a high school kid.
This is a teenager.
Junior.
Right. He's 16, 17.
Yeah.
He's not even 19. But people are attacking his character because he changed his mind based on what school he wanted to go to. Right. Which brings me to the point about character. A lot of people make these snap decisions about athletes like they know them just because they root for them or watch them play on TV or get to see them live in person, but have no clue who they are as individuals. And they question their character. Eric Gordon made a decision to come to Illinois because at the time, he didn't want to play for Indiana because of Mike Davis. They had a coaching change. His father has a relationship with the assistant coach at Indiana. His family
helped him make a decision.
Help him make that decision.
And it wasn't all just Eric Gordon.
Right.
Just like anybody else, a family's going to get to sit down with his son or his daughter to, hey, here's my opinion or here's my suggestion on the school I think or we think, fits you best.
Right. Now, just like this incident here with Jamar Smith, does this establish what kind of character he has? Probably not. Why not? He's still growing, as everybody said. He's still a young teenage student. He's still a young man. They always say the reasoning center in the brain for men is the last thing that develops. And when put in those situations, sometimes you don't make the right decision.
Sometimes you don't.
He didn't make the right decision. But to question Eric Gordon, and I bring this back to this Eric Gordon deal, to question his character because he changed schools, you might want to reserve your comments about athletes, like you know them, until you get to see the entire package. And this is what I'm bringing up about this Jamar Smith situation. You said it earlier. Jamar Smith, choir boy look, never had any problems in the past, et cetera. He had one mistake, and now people are saying, whoa, wait a minute. Let's not crucify him. I don't want to crucify him, but we can't judge a book based on its cover.
Right.
Can't do that.
And I'm not, I hate to say, this may be a good thing that this happened, but maybe Jamar Smith, and I hope, he's a kid, like everybody says, this might just turn him around, man, We got a caller, Joe.
Tell him like it is. Caller, are you there?
And
384-2452, 384-2452, UPTV.
Hello.
Tell it like it is, caller.
Yes, I do notice that both of you guys kind of agree on a lot of things together, but do both of you guys ever tell it like it is to each other? I mean, do y'all
always
have y'all disagreements?
Always.
Caller, you should see some of the disagreements we
always
have.
Always, man.
Oh, okay. I got a question, okay?
Go ahead.
Okay. And I want you, Mr. Stovall, to pick five NBA players, okay, that has retired in the last 3 years. Okay, and who you think that could come back and you know, they could play a good game, okay? And Mr. Della, I want you to do the same thing. Now, if y'all have disagreements about it, okay, y'all go at it, okay?
Five players who've retired in the past 3 years?
Yeah. Pick five NBA players, each one of y'all,
okay,
who have retired for the past, okay, let's say 2 years or more,
well,
okay,
yeah,
who you think that can come back right now and can show a good game.
Really haven't been that many, other than if you take, like, I'll give you an example, Karl Malone and John Stockton.
No.
Karl Malone and John Stockton, when they left, they were at the peak of their games, but they had been in the league for 20 years.
And there hasn't been no big-time retirements in the last – now, if you had to say 10 years
– or 5 or 10 years.
You know, it would have been something different, but there hasn't been no big major retirements in the last 2 years.
You know. But
if
I wanted to give out names, those two are my first two on the top of my list, is Malone and Stockton. When they left, like I said, they were at the top of their game in terms of the way they played basketball for the Utah Jazz. And then Malone ended up his career with the Lakers. Scottie Pippen was talking during All-Star break about coming back. He's another player who could come back and contribute.
Still in good shape.
I think he could come back and contribute. In terms of a couple more players, I really don't have anybody else to come. I mean, a guy like a Charles Barkley, he's been gone too long. Even Mike Jordan. When Mike left, Mike was really on the downside.
That's all about talk.
Of his
career. But look here, Albert, what he's saying is, tell it like it is. Like you said, the players he's naming, I'm going to have to concur, because there hasn't been no really the retired people, man. They're the older 10 years ago. You talk about the Kareems and they all done and said. But Jordan, I think Jordan he can't score like he used to, but I think he can contribute. Barkley.
What do you think about Rodman?
He's playing now. He's playing overseas now, but he can come back. He's been trying to come back, but. You know, Rodman can come back. There's, just like Joe said, you know, you got big old Barkley. Barkley can contribute. These guys here, they just don't sports announce. They still play ball. They play ball, you know, quite consistently. And they got teams and their own leagues and so on and so on.
Yeah, okay. Hey, I must say I appreciate everything, and I most definitely do like y'all's show and everything, okay?
Can I ask you something?
No problem.
Are you related to OK?
OJ?
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you say okay about 100 times, man. I just thought you knew somebody named OK. Hey, thanks for calling, man. We got a caller, Joe.
Tell it like it is.
He said okay about 50 times.
He said about...
After every word, let me say some okay. And okay.
And you know what? I'm okay with that.
I'm going to get him okay chain.
Right. If he okay...
I'm okay.
You okay?
I'm okay.
Okay.
Hey, you okay too, Al? You okay too, Al? Caller.
Hey.
What's going on?
Hey, long time listener, first time caller.
Hey, how you doing?
All right, Dollar. Hey, you guys are all talking about Jamar and everything and about not wanting to crucify him, and I understand that. He's a young man.
Yeah.
I agree with what you're saying, but don't you believe – I want to know, don't you believe he deserves some kind of repercussions for this? Because if y'all remember – Julia Wright's her campaign policy when she beat Pallon was the treatment the Illini players received with the incident y'all were talking about earlier.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of curious what y'all feel on that.
I agree. I think he should get some kind of repercussions. He should get some kind of discipline behind this, man.
Now, I agree.
I'm not saying throw the guy in the penitentiary for 3 to 5 years, but I think he should do some public service work. Mm-hmm. I mean, sometimes public service work for cats, you know, like, you know, Jamar Smith, who think he's, you know, hey, I'm Jamar Smith, Illinois basketball player, you know, top player coming out of Peoria, and help the community, you know. Right. Okay, you want to go ahead and tear down some trees, run into a tree with your grandmama car? Okay, we're going to have you plant trees. Or, you know, just help the community. I think something should be done.
Yeah, I think on the criminal side, I think that he shouldn't do any jail time.
Yeah.
But I think there should be a lengthy probation, or maybe even a suspended sentence. I think, number two, I agree with Dollar in terms of the community service work needs to be done, because this is a powerful message that can be sent not just to student athletes, but to just students in general, whether they be in elementary school all the way up to college, that drinking and driving doesn't mix. It's a simple message.
It doesn't.
And it's a powerful message. And I think the final thing in terms of the collar, in terms of repercussion, he's not playing basketball for the rest of this season, but I think this should also carry over into the start of next season if he's allowed to come back.
Right. And put him on some kind of like game suspension like they did McBride.
Yeah.
You know, put him on something like that. But I really do think he should do some public service work in the Champaign-Urbana area and help out the community as much as he can.
Thanks, fellas. I appreciate it.
Thanks, all right. Caller.
Y'all have a good one.
All right.
Thanks, caller. Appreciate that.
And like you said, I don't think jail time is the answer. And I don't think he's going to get into jail time. I really don't.
No.
But I think, like you said, he's going to be on a lengthy probation. And believe me, he will do some public service work. I guarantee you.
Oh, yeah.
If it ain't nothing but ringing that bell during December, Merry Christmas, he's going to be doing some public service work, man.
Because some people have said earlier about him getting a second chance.
I'm with it.
I'm with it, too.
I'm with it, man.
Because here's the thing. Let's look at it. If you can take anything positive out of this.
Yeah.
Carwell's fine.
Yep.
Smith's fine.
Yep.
It's just a car. Mm-hmm. They made
grandmama car.
Grandmama car. They made stupid mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
You know. So with that being said, there should be some punishment.
Right.
But we shouldn't just
let it go.
Throw the baby out with the bathwater.
And okay, that's it.
And here's why I say that. Because in a couple of weeks, what's going to happen on campus? Unofficial St. Patrick's Day.
Yep.
Now. We got kids waking up at 8 o'clock in the morning having keg parties
early.
On campus.
For how long?
From 8 in the morning until they can't walk.
How old are they?
18, 19, 20.
You know?
Underage drinking. And this is on the campus of the University of Illinois.
And that's when most of them bars on campus get the most citations. I mean you're gonna go ahead and, you know, discipline the kids, but how many times do you got to give a bar on campus, citate them, hey, you're serving underage drink? How many times do you got to write them tickets?
Money.
That's it.
Money. And that's why we're bringing this issue up about, even though unofficial St. Patrick's Day is not a sports-related issue, but it flows right into this segment because it shows you the hypocrisy. We look at athletes and want them to be different than anybody else.
Yep.
Now, they have a responsibility, as you said earlier, as being a role model. They have a lot of kids looking up to them and adults, but the fact remains, there are 17, 18, 19, 20-year-old kids on a sporting team here at the university, and you got the majority of students going out on one unofficial holiday to see how intoxicated they can get.
And that's when not only the basketball coach, that's when the football coach, the baseball coach, the volleyball coach, all the coaches of the U of I, that's when you should really watch your players. That's when you really should say, hey, guys, look, I know what's coming up, but I'm letting you know, if you were in this or if you're involved in this, if I hear your name, you're gone or you're suspended or something. This is when you got to babysit because these are kids.
Mm-hmm.
Mom and daddy's a long way from, you know, this camp.
That's why the coaches say, when you come here, I'm your mom and your daddy.
That's right, and they should be.
So with that being said, unofficial St. Patrick's Day, if you're going to get all over these athletes, look at our society in general and the way folks are just allowing students to run amok.
Well, I'm 25 years old, and I'm going to be drinking on St. Patrick's Day. Not that early, but I'm going to be putting them down.
First of all, you had 25 cups. You're not 25 years old. I'm just saying.
Next.
Yeah. So we want to let that know. Now, after we flow from that,
man, you know what?
You know you get so
get
sensitive.
It, man. No, I'm just.
What
saying.
Is it?
No, I. Why you got to tell people?
I wouldn't leave you in the car.
I won't tell people your real age.
I won't tell people your real age, but you're not 25.
Come on, man. Forget it.
Now we talk about age. 81 years. The Chief. He's gone.
Yep.
He did his last dance Wednesday night. At the Illinois-Michigan game, which people, Illinois won.
People crying.
People crying, people upset. Pro-Chief supporters out there. Yeah. Anti-Chief. People are saying, who won? Nobody won.
Yeah.
Let's first of all, let's put that on the table. Nobody has won. Mm-hmm. The anti-chief supporters didn't win because now he doesn't dance anymore. The pro-chief supporters weren't winning for the past 81 years.
Yeah.
The thing we got to look at from this is totally different. We're talking about power, privilege, and perspective.
The three P's.
The three P's is always talking about.
The three P's.
What people have to recognize when we're talking about power, privilege, and perspective is what puts you on the right or left side of an issue. For 81 years, the folks who were in power, who have the privilege and have the positive perspective of the chief, felt that he was an honored symbol. Mm-hmm. The folks who were not, for so many years, who don't have the power to make change and the privilege to put symbols out that they think are appropriate, had a negative perspective of the chief. And when those perspectives converge, this is what we got.
And you made a good point last week on the show. You know, when you were younger and you grew up here in Champaign, you know, you supported the chief and you was into it. But as you get older, you know, you understand the culture more.
Right.
And you know where they're coming from as far as, you know, what the chief represents. And I believe the kids on campus, like the girl that was crying, and the person made a good point. You know, maybe a change for Illinois is good.
Yeah.
You know, like you said, Baltimore Ravens, they used to be the Colts.
Yeah.
Now they're the Ravens, they won a championship. Yeah. Now the Colts are in Indianapolis.
Right.
They won a championship. So Illinois may change your name to the Fighting Billy Goats.
Squirrels.
Or Fighting Squirrels.
Anything.
And they may win it. NCAA championship, and then what? You see a bunch of people with goat and squirrel hats on.
That's it.
But I'll buy me a goat hat and a goat squirrel shirt.
I got two in my closet right now I can let you wear. We can kick the trade off.
They got to change the name first.
Right, but just to kind of close on it, obviously it's a serious and sensitive subject for people, but things have changed in this community and in this state and in this country. Whether you look at race relations between African Americans and Caucasians, whether you look at the change in immigration where folks were coming from Europe and now they're coming from Mexico and Central and South America, the fact remains that this country is always changing and the dynamics are always changing, and that changes the perspective and the power struggling within this particular community. Mm-hmm. And so with that being said, what was appropriate in 1970 is not appropriate in 2007.
Yeah.
You know, people say, well, you know, we're being too politically correct. Do we want to be incorrect? Do we want to go out of our way to offend our fellow man? I don't think that's the case. I think we are trying to come together. And sometimes with this change comes pain.
And it's getting better.
It is getting better.
It's getting better, man. It's
so
better,
to the pro-chief supporters, I say, cherish the 81 years. Relish the way the symbol was set up from your perspective, but understand that the people on the anti-chief side have a perspective too, awesome. And it's not, I think, to hurt or to demean those folks.
Right.
It's just they're looking at it to better the human race and overall society.
Right.
So that's my little editorial on the chief.
That's it. I'm going to give you A minus.
Okay, A minus.
A
on,
minus.
A minus on that?
Yeah, A minus.
I stood in the bathroom last night and did it in the mirror. And
this is the wrong show, man.
Oh.
You talking about a different show. Excuse what he just said, man.
I apologize.
Yeah.
Well, let's move on. We talked a lot about orange and blue and the chef and things of that nature, but basketball, NBA All-Star Game is coming gone, and something else is coming gone. The NBA trade deadline.
Right.
And guess who got traded? Nobody.
Not a soul.
Why do they even waste our time with telling us when the deadline is if you're not going to trade anybody?
Somebody, come on. You got to have at least one.
But one guy, right, one trade.
But let me just say this. Off of basketball, off of NBA basketball to NFL, you have got, this is one of the biggest news is it's on TV. Player for Tennessee went to the strip club.
Pac-Man Jones.
Lost. Left. No, not lost. He left $81,000 in the club. And now he demands it back. $81,000 cash. Pac-Man Jones went into a strip club, left $81,000 in the strip club, and now he wants it back.
Now, I've never been to a strip club. I've never been into an establishment
and
like
me
that.
Me either.
And Johnny Dollar's never been.
We've never. I don't, do they have any in Champaign?
I've heard people talk about them, but
I don't do that.
We're on the way to Bible study, I've heard.
But. $81,000.
My understanding is, when you leave money in the strip club,
it's gone.
It's gone.
Man, what? How is he carrying $81,000, man? He got to be walking with, I know he ain't got no knot like this.
He got 81,000 singles, and he was walking in the strip club.
And this dude is demanding.
It's me and my boys, and he made it rain.
Well, they said he carried it in with his briefcase. What are you going on? If let me tell you something, Pac-Man. I know this station can't carry as far as where you at, but I hope one of your buddies tell your other one of your buddies, and the other one of your buddies, the other buddy.
Phone a friend.
That tell like this. You's a fool, man. You's a fool. I hope you don't get a dime back of that money. And I hope the dancers and the people there watching the dancers and the waitresses and the bartenders, I hope they all got their little piece of chain. Because I'm telling you, I don't go strip club. But if I was in that strip club,
you'd have had some of that money too, wouldn't you?
Man, you'd be seeing me leave. I'd be having money all in my belt loops.
You'd have had a G-string.
I would have had a G-string on myself. You heard me?
Tell it like it is.
Tell it like it is.
You know, well, forget him.
Yeah, he's.
You know what needs to happen? Pac-Man Jones and Tim Hardaway need to get a little Volkswagen Beetle and ride somewhere and sit down and think about life.
Wow.
Because if you Tim Hardaway, you know right now, you scratch your head going, why did I say that? And if you're Pac-Man Jones, you're going, man, why did I just carry an ATM card?
You know at least one person got at least 20-something.
Oh, please, come on.
Somebody, one of the dancers done quit.
That's her 401k.
Right.
Thank you, Pac-Man.
Yeah.
But back to the NBA, like we said, no trades.
No trades, man. Well, we thought there was going to be a big one, though. But it
Jason Kidd was supposed to go to L.A. Vince Carter was
getting
all of this. And then blah, 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 blah. Nobody.
Yeah, skip them.
Right. NBA, you just got, tell like it is, nope.
No you talk mean, about. No business.
No more.
Don't ask nothing about the NBA because there ain't nothing to talk about.
But you know what we need to talk about?
Man, you got to talk about NASCAR.
NASCAR! Man.
I'm going to say this. Now, I don't watch that much NASCAR, but that race this past weekend was especially the finish. That's, you know, on ESPN Classic, do they have NASCAR races?
I don't know, but well, they should.
They will.
After this one,
that was an ESPN Classic that is going to go down in the NASCAR racing books forever.
.02 seconds.
And not only that.
In the back of them. It looked like folks was on the Dan Ryan in Chicago.
But who was that finished on his head?
I couldn't tell you. Number 20, he came in upside down.
Finished, and then his car
then went into the infield.
And flipped over.
Flipped over.
Landed on four tires.
And then he climbed that car on fire.
On fire.
Now, that's racing.
I mean, I'm telling you, I sat there like, wow. I do not believe it.
You know what? It had mud and grass. John Madden should have been doing the announcing. Just all the mud and grass.
Just think how Cosell had been, you know, still in the... Well, here we go again. And they're coming down the stretch. And here it... Oh, my, look behind... Forget who won the race. Look what's going on behind the winner, ladies and gentlemen. Man, that was something else, man.
Yeah, but that was...
The finish was excellent, but the after the finish was,
right,
was exciting.
The guys who got third on back put on a show. So
it did, man.
NASCAR fans, we've been asking y'all to call, help us out, give us a buzz, you know. Now, we said we was crossing out the NBA.
Wow.
We are going to cross out the NBA, except we lost an NBA legend yesterday.
Well, they're saying he's trying to make a decision on if he wants to come back or have the surgery.
Forget him. I ain't even talking about Dwayne Wade.
Okay, you won't forget him. We're not talking about Wade either.
We ain't talking about, because he's a current NBA player.
Okay.
And since the NBA didn't make any trades, we're not going to talk about him either. I'm talking about DJ Dennis Johnson. 52 years old,
young
52
man.
Years young.
Young man.
We lost a legend.
Yeah.
passed away in practice. He's a coach. DJ played for Seattle. Remember DJ when he played with the Wizard, Gus Williams, Gus Johnson, Downtown Freddie Brown, Lonnie Shelton, and my boy back at Illinois State used to call Jack Sigma, Jack Sigma, because he was a Sigma.
But
DJ was one of the coldest big guards to come into the NBA. Played with Larry Bird after he left Seattle,
That's what you're remembering the best with Boston.
You remember the call, Isaiah threw the inbounds pass.
Oh, yeah.
Bird with the steal, over to DJ for the layup. Dennis Johnson. And he was one of those guys that you don't remember Dennis Johnson for one particular thing.
No.
You know how Dr. J with his dunks.
And you remember Dennis Johnson for his defensive awards year after year after year.
Year after year.
Defensive player 3 years in a row.
Right.
You know, he's up for the Hall of Fame again.
And I can't believe he's not in.
Yeah. And you know what? It'd be sad. I'm not saying it'd be sad, but it's terrible. He passed away, and all of a sudden this year they want to put him in because.
You should smell your flowers before you go.
Yeah.
So Dennis Johnson, rest in peace, brother. You one of my favorite, even though I hate the Boston Celtics with a passion because I grew up as a 76ers fan, but I could not hate DJ because DJ was one of the best overall all-around basketball players to lace him up. We'll see you at the crossroads, DJ. Now.
But not too soon.
I hope.
Not too soon.
Not too soon. Keep over live. Keep over live. Now, we were talking the other day. Tennis. Tell it like it is. We talk about everything.
Tell it like it is, man.
Now they got a controversy
they won't get paid the same.
Going on at Wimbledon. The men get paid more than the women. Now, the reasoning behind it is the folks over there and across the pond say is that because the men play more sets.
Right.
You got to win 3 out of 5 sets to win a match.
Right.
For the women, it's 2 out of 3.
Right.
But when we were talking about this, you made a comment, and I said, you know, the women have the better draw, and you said they also had a better. It's tell it like it is. Tell it like it is. I said the women have the better draw, and you said the women have the better
draws.
That's all I wanted you to do.
They do. And women attracts me.
They sure enough do.
Women had a better draws.
The women had a better draws.
Yeah.
And if you want to call and talk about them, hit us at 384-2452.
Yeah.
Tell it like it is. Stat girl.
I believe there's some women can be some men. She's like, you late. You late, Stat girl.
That's the reason why.
We're going to tell like it is. You were late.
You were late. We missed about 4 calls because of you.
Yeah.
But, you know, we understand.
You was late.
Now, another exciting NFL offseason. You know, they got the combine going on, et cetera. What's happening up in Chicago now that the Super Bowl's over with the coaching staff?
Well, they hired a defensive line coach today. They hired a linebackers coach today. And the running back says, I want out.
But who else is gone? The defense coordinator.
Riviera.
Ron Rivera, Riviera?
Riviera, Buick, Skylark, whatever his name is.
He's gone. And I think what that tells me is, first of all, I think what the Bears were banking on was that he was going to get one of these jobs with one of these teams that were looking for either head coach or defense coordinator, and the Bears would not have egg on their face in terms of just turning him loose. He went through about 19,000 interviews, didn't get one job. Then the Bears said, we ain't bringing you back. So to me, maybe the management of the Chicago Bears were thinking if we fire him right after the Super Bowl, it might hurt his chances, so we're going to keep him on. But not to bring him back, I'm kind of surprised by that.
Yeah.
And then Lovey promoted Bob Babich, who he's known since he was at Tulsa way back in the day. So, you know, just wondering. And like I said, Thomas Jones.
He wants out.
Wade Wilson, he's gone. Quarterbacks coach who worked with Rex Grossman. He's down in Dallas now.
Well, the way Rex thrown, he probably needs to go.
Yeah.
The way Rex throwing the ball, probably the best move. Yeah, he had to go. He's got to pop some smoke.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, if Jones leaves, if Jones leaves, Benson is not a – I don't think he's an every-down back. He's a straight-ahead runner. And like I told you here a couple weeks ago, NFL need cutbacks. They need running backs that can cut back, like the LaDainian Thomasons and the running backs like the St. Louis Barber. You got to have cut. You got to be able to cut back if you want to dodge these big catch. Yeah. You cannot run straight at these 250-pound linebackers and 350-pound linemen. Think you're gonna run through them? It ain't gonna happen.
Right. Well, it's gonna be interesting to see what happens with the draft coming up in April, right. Free agency starting in a week. In terms of Bears gonna let Thomas Jones go, and are they gonna go out and pick up another running back like you said, somebody with a little shiftier moves and some of that nature? Because they can't go into the season with Cedric Benson as the lead runner.
Well, Dylan, he wants out of New England.
But he's that those old legs. You don't want that coming to Chicago.
Give him you know, let that one two down. He might help us out. You know?
He probably needs to
be a third down back somewhere, make a little easy check.
That's it. You know, you go ahead and go to the draft, get somebody in the third round. They might be able to come in.
Well, who's the top running back coming out the draft, Joe? Is it
Adrian Peterson? Adrian Peterson, Oklahoma. Now, you know he had a separated shoulder, but he's a horse. 6'2", 230 pounds, runs a 4.4, but he'll be gone early, third pick. He might go to Detroit, you know. Or if not Detroit, he may go to Cleveland. You know, Cleveland just won the third pick in the draft with a coin flip with Tampa Bay today. So they got the draft order all set up.
But. Okay. Well, we got a caller. And, no, I guess we don't. Yes, we do. Caller, tell it like it is. What's going on?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, I was wanting in on this Jamar Smith.
Okay.
I understand that he, and I think you're right about the public service work, but I feel like it should be in the emergency room of the hospital. That would be a good place to work.
Excellent point,
caller. That's a good point.
And then when if he gets tired of that, the Humane Society can use a lot. Now, I love him very much. I've been so fond of all of these players, and I said, I feel like I know he made a mistake, but when you're under the influence, your brain is damaged with booze, you don't make the right decision. And I feel he intentionally would never have done that to a person he loves so much.
Right.
And I just don't think that I would like to see him punished. I mean, to get thrown off the ball team might be fine, but not to interfere with his education and his career.
Right. I agree. And as far as him working at the hospital and the humane, I think that's good.
That's an excellent point.
I mean, that really can wake you up, man.
And I wish you had closed caption. I can't catch you. Where are you located?
Here in Urbana, Illinois at the
Urbana City Council Chambers.
City Council Chambers.
Well, I'm used to closed caption. I said I'm older, and I, you know, I do love these ball games, and I love every one of those players, and I feel so sorry for them and so sorry for Bruce. And I said, you know, we have to forgive. If we want God to forgive us, we sure have to forgive, because there's not a one of us perfect.
That's right. And what's your name, ma'am? What's your name?
My name?
Yeah.
I'm Velma Lammers from St. Joe.
Well, thanks for calling, and we hope you call back every week.
All right. Thank you. Bye-bye.
See ya.
Now, that's how you tell it like it is.
That's how you tell it like it is, man. You can't beat it.
You can't beat that. That's how you wrap up a situation like that. Now, I know earlier when we kicked the show off, you got on me for looking at the magazine.
Okay, go ahead and talk about it.
I'm just saying.
We only got a few minutes. Talk about it, man.
Beyonce,
wow,
is on the cover of Sports Illustrated as the swimsuit issue has come out.
Wow. Why don't they have Holly Berry in there, man?
Huh?
Why don't they got Holly Berry in there, man?
Huh? Oh, why don't they have Holly Berry in there? Is that what you were saying?
Nothing, man. Forget it. I see this magazine got you all twisted. It got some messed up people.
I like it because of the articles.
Oh, so you're reading the article.
I'm reading.
So you're not.
Haven't you seen some of the great ads and articles in this? This is one of the best. Now that one, we won't talk about that there. But
well, if anybody got this here magazine, go over to Burt Reynolds' part. That looks terrible.
There is a shot of
that looks like a hairy tree. Or
it looks like Sasquatch is in a photo shoot. I don't know how to
work.
That was terrible. But Beyonce, Jay-Z.
Wow. You know, somebody said Beyonce breath stank. That's the rumor going around in the Hollywood news. They said Beyonce got some funky breath.
Okay, so what you're saying is that you wouldn't give her a Tic Tac.
I would give her a whole bell of Tic Tacs. I don't want no stanky breath woman. I don't care how good you look. If your breath stank.
So let me ask you to close out the show.
What?
Would you rather have an ugly woman with fresh breath or a beautiful woman with stanky breath? Tell her like it is.
Give me Beyonce the stanky breath. Beyonce, I'll take your stanky breath. I'll take it. Give me, I can't walk around an ugly woman, man.
There ain't no stanky breath there.
Okay.
And they make, breath
I don't mints believe what I hear anyway. I got to see for myself.
So you're going to get all in her group.
Right, I'm going to.
And she's going to give you the old, hi, Harvey. Yeah,
well. But again, Joe, nice show.
Stat girl. Thank you.
Khalid, cameraman.
Everybody.
Everybody did a good job.
Hey, you out there.
Thanks for calling in, the callers. And you too, okay. Because he said okay about 100 times.
But what the lady say her name was? Thelma, Elma, from St. Joe. That's how you tell it like it is.
Thanks for calling.
Appreciate it.
What you looking at?
Step your game up.
What you waiting for?
Step your game up.
You are watching a master at work.
You ready? Let's go. Yeah. For those of you that want to know what we're all about, it's like this, y'all.
This is 10% luck, 20% skill, 15% concentrated power.
This is J&J Sports live TV every Friday at 7 o'clock. But we got a super special bowl edition. What day? Cut.
They said a super special bowl.
A special